Hello. Can I help you?
Your attention, please. My name is Regus Patoff.
And my name is Jack. The Consultant is released, a new Amazon Prime show featuring star and Oscar-winning actor Christoph Waltz. I am Jack and worked for 5 years as a consultant and project manager for the world's leading management consulting firm McKinsey & Company. And in this review video, I will tell you if The Consultant offers a realistic picture of professional McKinsey-style consulting work or just a parody. What is the show about? This is the one-sentence summary Amazon Prime offers.
When a new consultant, Regus Patoff, is hired to improve the business at the app-based gaming company Compware, employees experience new demands and challenges that put everything into question.
I assure you that this video is spoiler-free. In this initial video, I only refer to the trailer and teaser videos that are publicly available on the Prime Video YouTube channel. So, who again is the client here?
We work for the most successful mobile game studio in Los Angeles. But suddenly, our CEO is gone. And then he arrived.
Dude, this is a startup and you wear a suit and tie? As a professional consultant, you always try to adapt to a dress code in your client company. Let me also try to get just a bit more casual. How does the consultant introduce himself to the workforce?
Good morning, comrades. Unfortunately, Mr. Sang cannot be with us today, but he sends his best regards to the wonderful faces I see below. Thank you for being an important part in Compware's success.
This is wrong on so many levels. I mean, he uses military language to address his people, and then he talks from the top to the bottom faces. And there's this red carpet leading up the stairs. It's so wrong. He makes a second point in his opening speech to make new friends immediately.
For those who work remotely, you have exactly 1 hour to get here in person or your contracts of employment will be terminated.
The positive or negative effects of remote work from home are contentious, but of course this opening statement is just ridiculous. It reminds me though of what happened when Elon Musk took over Twitter. So in this entrepreneur article, it says, in his first email to staff as CEO of Twitter, Elon Musk informed them that they were no longer permitted to work from home unless given explicit permission by Musk himself. Elon Musk made a similar communication to his Tesla employees, so his email back then said, anyone who wishes to do remote work must be in the office for a minimum, and I mean minimum of 40 hours per week, or depart Tesla. Well, you know that shortly after the acquisition, many Twitter employees did depart the company. Maybe this is the management style of the future? The show drives the consultant's policy for all remote workers to be back in the office within 1 hour or to get fired to the extreme.
Let her in.
I gave them all 1 hour.
She's right there if you just open.
Why should I make an exception for her? What's different about this employee from the others?
Obviously, no consultant, actually no human being, would act as mercilessly as Regus Patoff in this scene, especially given the employee is disabled. All consulting firms are extremely concerned of any sort of discrimination. Also, empathy is important to build a connection. Let's see what Regus does in his opening speech to show empathy.
I'm looking forward to getting to know you all personally. You're valued.
But execution is lacking a little.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
The opposite of empathy. And the smell test has bad consequences.
He's firing Ian. Says he doesn't like the way he smells.
Bow your heads and pray for him.
Oh Lord, a consultant or manager is interested in the performance of their employees, not their smell. And certainly, a consultant would not state smell as a reason to fire somebody. So, Regus tries to manage by fear, but that can only last you for a couple of days. If you don't manage to make friends in your client company within a few days, they will sabotage and reject you. What else do we know about Regus Patoff?
I offer a very simple service.
My purpose is to improve the business.
Let's go back a little. Yes, consultants tend to be a bit vain and also concerned about their appearance. But what is this? I mean, I see no computer, no laptop, just papers and a calculator. This is a desk from the 80s. And he as well, I mean, scribbling in the papers, where's MS Excel? And then he symbolically wipes out everything what Compre has done or thought before. This is perfect to make employees feel terrible. There also is a snippet on how to deal with stress.
Some excel under stress.
Maybe he's just really good at his job.
Some break. You're breathing too fast. Now breathe with me. In. Out.
Classic parody, but also there's a truth in it. You don't cure the root causes of stress, but just its symptoms. All this makes the staff rightly conclude.
We were for sociopath.
The sad truth is that I have met a few sociopaths at McKinsey too. In hindsight, they were mostly senior partners and partners, but they were in the minority. There is another interesting scene featuring how Regus convinces his client, Sang, the CEO of Compre, to hire him.
Sang is highly intelligent at coding, creating his first game at the age of 13 in South Korea. Sang is quiet and doesn't have the greatest rapport with his staff.
I don't need a consultant.
So Sang says he lacks rapport with his staff and then hires a sociopath to help him? That makes zero sense. Let's watch how Regus manages to convince Sang to hire him.
Engage my services, Mr. Sang, and your concerns will cease to be.
When can you start?
Guys, I work as an independent management advisor. Do you believe it is that easy to win new clients and projects? Where are the project proposal documents, the endless emails, trust building and supporting facts and references? No guys, this is not how it works. You can see that Regus Patoff embodies many characteristics of how a consultant should not be. He is an anti-consultant. And there's more to this show.
There's literally nothing online about it.
Some other CEO hired Patoff.
And he was killed 2 weeks later.
What if he's more than just a consultant?
What the hell? Stop the car!
And
this guy, he's not who he pretends to be.
So let's hope he's a killer and not an actual consultant. However, I promised you no spoilers here. Let me know in the comments if you'd like me to review the actual episodes too. And don't forget to subscribe for further top quality content from the business and consulting world. Finally, Regus is able to offer some comfort too.
I won't be here forever. I'm only the consultant.